Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here from DocSports.com. Welcome to the opening salvo report for Friday, June 15th, 2018. Free baseball play coming up in just a moment. First, a quick note, if you've yet to become a member at DocSports.com, be sure to click on the link below the video. Set yourself up for a free $60 account. Can be used on World Cup Soccer, CFL, baseball, what have you. And speaking of World Cup Soccer, got underway last night. We passed yesterday's lone game, Russia clobbering Saudi Arabia 5-0. We also passed the opening night in the CFL, Edmonton a 33-30 winner, Winnipeg getting the cover. They were about a touchdown underdog in that one. But I wanted to bring up the CFL for one quick minute. Last night's game, the perfect example of why you don't chase moves. You do not chase steam. If you saw that Edmonton-Winnipeg total, it opened up around 53 or so. It dropped 3 points rather quickly down to 50 going into Thursday. And people keep betting it more and more, the under throughout the day, all the way down to 47, 47 and a half. I kind of liked it under. I didn't bet it. I didn't grab that 53 out of the blocks, and I was not going to chase steam because, you know, after doing this and being in the sports betting business for over 25 years, that doing so is going to not pay off. It's going to hurt your bankroll in the long run, and we saw a perfect example last night. Folks kept chasing the steam, chasing the under, and lost. Again, 33-30, Edmonton wins the game, final score. You would have lost even if you got 53, but the point is, you do not chase the steam. It dropped 6 points or so from where it opened. Great and perfect example of not chasing steam right out of the blocks for the Canadian Football League. Also wanted to mention, we're not personally in action, but World Cup play action going about 4 hours after we get done with this video, posted it all over the place. And I'll be in action at 11 a.m. Eastern. The battle between Iran and Morocco, we're in that game. That's available at DocSports.com, along with the big five-star World Cup play for Saturday. Our first big play goes on Saturday in World Cup action. You can grab that right now exclusively at DocSports.com. We've got a three-star in the CFL. Our first CFL play goes on Friday. That's at DocSports, and a big six-star play in Saturday's CFL. You'll want to grab those also. And a big five-star play in Major League Baseball goes on Friday. We're back in action after a pass in baseball on Thursday. We headed to Friday's card, by the way, 7-1 the last 8 days in baseball, up $3,040, betting $100 per unit. All right, let's get to the information for Friday. First, the early mover. It's on the Washington Nationals, pretty significant. They've gone up a good 15 to 20 cents already. The Nats now laying about $1.40 with Gio Gonzalez on the mound over Sanchez. Again, that price up a good 20 cents in some shops just in the last few hours. That is the big and significant early mover for Friday's card. Looks like sharp action came in on Washington. Not going to play it. Pricey now. We're going to sit back. I think Washington's the right play, but again, it's up to $1.40 and going to climb, it looks like. Free pick for us on Friday. The Colorado Rockies going to get the nod for us. We cashed last night with Boston. We'll look to make it two straight here, this time in interleague action. And as far as this Colorado Rockies team is concerned, they hit a little rough patch, but now they're on the road where they're 22-16. Texas, they've been horrible at home. They've won 13 of 36. How about 10-25 in the last 35 games against right-handed starters? And Bettis is going for the Rockies. What a home road dichotomy. You want to stay away from this guy and look to play against him when he's at home at Coors Field. He goes on the road, different story. 4-1 record, 2.03 ERA. The opposing batting average against Bettis on the road, under 200, 198 to be exact. Mendez will go for the home team in this particular game for Texas, and we're going to go against him here. He's already had just one appearance basically thus far. He's only pitched two-thirds of an inning so far this year. This will be his first start, his second appearance for Texas, and we think the Rocky Bats will get to the Southpaw. The Rockies are the free pick. They get the nod for Friday, about $1.10 favorite as we speak. Hey, if you like what you see, click on the thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. We appreciate those who have done so thus far. We're going to be right back here on Saturday morning by 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific. You know the drill. Put Friday in the win column right back here on Saturday morning before the crack of dawn.